that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to the holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. I like the former translation that said, what good would life have been for to us if Christ had not come as our Redeemer? Truly, what good would life have been if Christ had not come as our Redeemer? O wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. God's incomprehensible love to do such a thing. And so we say, O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ, O happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. That phrase, happy fault, in Latin is felix culpa. And I'm sure you've heard that and probably heard me preach about it in previous years, or somebody. It's one of the most well-known phrases, happy fault. Sometimes we even use, even secular people might use it when something went wrong, but good came from it. Oh, wonder of your humble care. And then we come to these verses which seem so appropriate considering what we've been through for the past 2 years. Dazzling is the night for me and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. O truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. And then the exalted concludes, may the flame, and this is the paschal candle, by the way, and this is the flame, may the flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Easter can never be suppressed or extinguished in our hearts. Blessing the fire before Easter, we did that last night, right after, well, when it was getting dark, and we call it the new fire. In the blessing of the new fire, the priest prays, that we may be so inflamed with heavenly desire that with minds made pure, we may attain festivities of unending splendor. And then when I prepared the Easter candle last night, I say these words, Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him, all and all ages. To him be glory and power through every age forever. Amen. I remember reading about a Jesuit priest who was in prison in Siberia, Walter Chizek. He died in 1984. He was a Polish-American who went he wanted to go into Russia, and then World War II broke out, but he ended up going disguised as a coal miner, and then someone spied on him or ratted on him, and he was apprehended and imprisoned for 23 years as a spy of the Vatican. He wrote a book called With God in Russia, and he tells of his first Easter after he got out of Lubyanka, which is the infamous prison in Moscow. He went to the Siberian labor camps, and so in his first Easter, he was let free from the labor camp, but he still was under a kind of arrest. He lived in the town. By the way, they built these incredible cities in Siberia with this slave labor, or this, well, it was basically slave labor, prisoners. There's incredibly large cities in Siberia. But once he got out of the Siberian camp, he still was restricted to stay in those cities. And so he began to practice his priesthood again. In fact, he was doing it all the time he was a prisoner, but he was out in the city. And he speaks of his first Easter in Norilsk. Ordinary poor people packed the room when he celebrated the Easter vigil. He describes how clandestine it was. In the pre-dawn hours, the people poured into the streets, returning to their homes before sunup so the communist government wouldn't find them or do something worse. I was struck by the fact that even in communist Russia, Easter could not be suppressed. So what does Easter mean to you? It's sort of being whitewashed by secularism. Even my own family, one of my brothers sent me a lovely Easter greeting with the Easter bunny. I couldn't say for sure whether they even went to services. I'm glad to see so many of you here, and I do not disparage Easter Catholics. We wish you would come every Sunday, and you should, and it is an obligation. However, the fact that you're here means that you're Christian. Why else would you be here? Why else would you be here? So that's something that to hold on to. The good news of our Lord's resurrection is not just information, not even social communication. It is good news that makes things happen because it changes us. How? By giving us hope, divine hope, the hope of a new life. And so I'll conclude with that thought. This really is a feast of hope. And we've come a long way in 2,000 years of Christianity, and maybe 10,000 or a million years of human habitation on this planet. And there's still a lot of things going on. When you think of what the Christian church has done, the Christianity has done in the world with schools, hospitals, good works of every kind, and so on and so forth, it's hard to imagine what it might have been like if Christ had not come as our Redeemer. What good would it have been to have been born if Christ hadn't been come, we sang. But still, this is not heaven. It's not heaven yet. We're still pilgrims, and we have to hang on to that hope. Maybe the Ukraine people in Ukraine are an example of that now. They are Christian people, and they're going through a lot. But we don't have to look as far away as Ukraine. We have people right on the border that with some hope, and it's not merely human, I don't think. It's inspired by something heavenly that they hope for something better. But the real hope is in victory over death. And we do believe in that, and we have to, you know, remind ourselves that we're only put on earth a little space that we may learn to bear the beams of love and practice our Lord's commandment to love one another. But this is a very short journey. It may feel long in times of suffering and trial, but it's really very short. And hope makes us a very resilient people. So we have our eyes fixed on Jesus Christ. We're headed for heaven. And on the way, we make this the best place we can possibly make it. So it's not just about only thinking of heaven. It's about bringing heaven down to earth, to your own home, to your own house, to your own community. May God bless you, and may you truly have a blessed Easter, not just today, but throughout the year. We don't do the creed today. We do our renewal of our baptismal promises. So please stand. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in his holy church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Enlivened by the joy of our Easter Alleluia, we turn to the Father who raised Jesus from the dead.
For the successors of the apostles in the church today, commissioned to preach to the people that, like Peter, they may boldly proclaim the resurrection of Christ and the forgiveness of sins in his name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus, the great cornerstone, may not be rejected by the builders of our society, but that the right hand of the Lord may be exalted in him, building nations with life, justice, morality, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that our life may be hidden with Christ in God, and that we may seek what is above, celebrating this feast with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all Christians may offer to the Paschal victim their thankful praises today, renewing their vows to him with joy and gratitude for his victory of divine love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for all who suffer, who grieve, who are distressed in mind and heart, that Jesus, who brought unexpected exaltation to Mary Magdalene and the apostles on that first Easter Sunday, may give them also a share of his rising to new life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of our relatives and friends who have gone before us, and especially Angie Amaro, for whom this Mass is offered, that they may all rest in the eternal peace of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Finally, we pause for a moment in silence and present to our Heavenly Father the petitions we carry within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Christ is risen. He is truly risen. Bless us, Father, with the assurance of your Son's risen presence in our lives. For Jesus is our Lord, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us sing, ye sons and daughters, number 185 in your spirit and psalm books. Again, that's number 185.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. Accept, we pray, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may by the working of your power bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse,
with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Augustine, patron of the diocese, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Angie, and to all our who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us show to one another the sign of peace.
On this day, quid tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On this day, quid tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter into thy dwelling, but only for the Lord.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Our communion song is Miracle of Grace, number 254 in your spirit and song books, number 254.
Joy, no one can deny. gracias sea dadas al Padre que nos pasó su reino.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Here are some important announcements which may be found in today's bulletin. Please support our Fiesta de la Familia. You can find a list of items in the parish bulletin. Items can be taken to the parish office. The parish office will be closed Monday, April 18th in observance of Easter. After Mass, we will have available for purchase delicious, authentic Middle Eastern treats prepared fresh and locally by Naeed, that lives in our parish only. Thank you.
Yeah, those Middle Eastern pastries are outside here in the courtyard. Thank you for coming, and remember, we're in the octave of Easter, so every day of this week is like an Easter day, and next Sunday is the Sunday of the octave of Easter, so it's a Divine Mercy Sunday. We may have an extra Mass, but with only two priests here, I'm not sure we can do it, but we will want to have some devotions anyway to the Divine Mercy. And for those of you who are praying the Novena to the Divine Mercy, keep me and Father David in your prayers, and indeed our entire parish. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Hallelujah, Love is Alive, number 177 in your spirit and song books, number 177.
People of God, see the morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run.
to the tomb, come and see, come and see. The sun has arisen.